Today's topic is graph theory. Now, what is graph? The diagrammatic representation of a finite number of dots or points together with lines joining certain pair of these points is called graph. Okay, for example, say this is a graph. Okay, here is there is 5 points and some pair of lines, say 5. This is a graph. Figure 1 is a graph. Now, what is vertex? The dots used in the graph is called vertices. In figure 1, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 are vertices. Okay, now edge. The line joining certain pair of vertices pair of dots of a graph is called edges. In figure 1, E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6 are edges. Here E1 joined by V1 and V2. E6 joined by V4 and V4. Okay. Now, what is vertex set? Vertex set. The set of all vertex is called the vertex set of a graph. And it is denoted by capital V. In figure 1, V represents, capital V represents V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. Next we have to know that what is edge set. The set of all edges is called the edge set of a graph. It is denoted by capital E. In figure 1, capital E represents E1, E2, E3, E4, E5 and E6. Next, self loop. An edge whose two end vertices are same is called a self loop. Called a self loop. In figure 1, the edge E6 is a self loop. Next, parallel edge. There may exist more than one edges associated with a given pair of vertices. Such edge is called parallel edge. In figure 1, the edge E2 and E5 are parallels. Next, we have to know that what is simple graph. A graph having no parallel edge and no self loop is called a simple graph. Figure 1 is not a simple graph, but the following figure is a simple graph. So figure 2 is a simple graph with 5 vertices and 6 edges. Okay, then incidence. When a vertex is an end vertex of an edge, then the vertex and the edge are called incident to each other. In figure 2, the vertex B and edge F are incident to each other. Here F is also incident to E. And in figure 1, no edge is incident to the vertex V5. Okay. Then we have to know that what is adjacent edge, adjacent vertex first. Adjacent vertex. Two vertex are said to be adjacent if they are end vertices of the same edge. So in figure 2, the vertices C and D are adjacent. A and C are not adjacent. Next, adjacent edge. Two non-parallel edges are said to be adjacent if they are incident to a common vertex. So in figure 2, edge C and D are adjacent, but A and C are not adjacent. Next, we have to know that what is degree of the vertex. The number of edges incident to a vertex with self loop counted twice is called the degree of the vertex. It is denoted by degree of VI. In figure 1, degree of V3 is equals to 3, as there are 3 edges connected with V3, and degree of V4 is equals to 4, because there are 1 self loop which is connected counted as 2 and 2 edges, that is 4, and degree of V5 is equals to 0, as no edge connected with V5. Next, even and odd vertex. A vertex is called odd or even depending on whether its degree is odd or even. In figure 2, the vertex B is odd vertex, as degree of B is equals to 3 and C is even vertex, as degree of C is equals to 2. Next, regular graph. A graph in which all vertices are of equal degree is called a regular graph. For example, figure 3 is a regular graph. Of degree 2. So that means it will be called 2 regular graph. It is called 2 regular graph. Next, we have to know that what is isolated vertex. There may exist some vertex which are not connected by any lines. That means a vertex having no edge connected with it is called an isolated vertex. In figure 1, V5 is an isolated vertex. And degree of isolated vertex is equals to 0. Then pendant vertex. And pendant edge also. A vertex whose degree is 1 is called pendant vertex. And an edge connected with a pendant vertex with a pendant vertex is called pendant edge. See, for example, for this graph, in figure 4, capital D is a pendant vertex with degree 1 and small d is a pendant edge. Next, null graph. A graph having no edge is called a null graph. The edge set of a null graph is a null set, and the vertex set of a graph cannot be a null set or empty set. Okay, for example, in figure 5 is a null graph with some with 4 points v1, v2, v3 and v4. Next, we have to know that what is complete graph. A simple graph is called a complete graph if each pair of distinct vertices is joined by an edges. A complete graph with n vertices is denoted by Kn. Figure 4 is not a complete graph. Figure 6 is a complete graph, as all the points A, B, C and D are joined to each other. This is a complete graph. And a complete graph is always a regular graph, but regular graph is not a complete graph. Complete graph is always a regular graph, but regular graph may not be a may or may not be a complete graph. Next, we have to know that bipartite graph. A simple graph, capital G, is called a bipartite graph if the vertex set V of capital G can be partitioned into two non-empty subset V1 and V2 such that each edge of capital G is incident to one vertex in V1 and one vertex in V2. In figure 7, Figure 7 is a bipartite graph. Bipartite graph. Because as the vertex set V, that is A, B, C, D and E, can be partitioned into two subset V1, A, C and E, and V2, B and D. We see here edge BC, incident to capital B, which is belongs to V2, and capital C belongs to V1, and similarly edge AB is incident to capital A, belongs to V1, and B belongs to V2, and so on. Edge AD also, in edge AD, capital D belongs to V2 and capital A belongs to V1. So it is a bipartite graph. That means we can write here also, that is A, B, C, D, E is the set, which is A, C, E, V1 union of V2, that is B, D. Okay. Next, we have to know that what is complete bipartite graph. A bipartite graph, capital G, with two partition vertex set V1 and V2 is called complete bipartite graph.